Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at one of the new features inside of DaVinci Resolve 18.5, and it's Infusion, and it is the multi-merge node, which is actually very helpful and a fantastic new feature. So let's just jump into DaVinci Resolve and have a look at what this new node can do for your workflow, because it's going to make things a bit faster. Instead of making multiple merge nodes, you can now just use one and then plug in your different things into one merge node. So let's just have a look at how that works. So let's get right to it. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve having a look at the multi-merge node inside of Fusion. And this is also a revisit to a old tutorial I did about how to do a basic animation. And in that video, I did that, but using merge nodes, and it was a mess of merge nodes. So this should, in theory, look a little bit better for a viewer's perspective, and it's also going to look a little bit better for the one who are doing the compositing. So first off, let's just jump up to the effects, and let's go into effects, and then we are just going to take a Fusion composition, and I'm going to put that down to the timeline, select that, and I'm going to jump directly into Fusion. And all we have now in Fusion is, of course, our media out node, but I want to have something here. I want to add in a background, just like that, and I'm going to connect that to the media out. And let's go into the inspector and change the color to, let's say, some kind of a bluish color. Let's take this one. Great. So here I have a bunch of PNG files, which are, as you see right here, I'm just going to put one down here, and I'm going to push one on my keyboard to show this in the second or the first viewer. So this is what I have, a background node. And a good practice here would be to rename all of your node. So you could do that by, depending on your, if you're on PC, you just need to push F2. But if you're on Mac, you're going to push function F2 to rename. And we're just going to call this man bg, man background, and say okay. And the main reason why it is super important to actually rename your clips, because if you have 12 of them and they are just called media in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's going to be pretty different or difficult when you want to actually put those together. So that's just one thing to keep in mind here. So first off, I'm going to rename all of the clips, and I'm going to speed this really, really up so you don't have to waste your time. So be back in one sec. Okay, so here I'm back after renaming all of them, and I have 17 nodes, which in the old tutorial were 17 merge nodes all merged together. But now we're going to do this with the multi-merge node, and you can find the multi-merge node in two different ways. Either you're going to push shift spacebar, and then you can just write multi, and then it's right here, multi-merge node, and you can just add that in. Or of course, it's also here in the tools right here, so you can just drag it from there and put it in between the background and the media out. So now we just need to plug in our background. So we have here a man background. We're going to put that in. And of course, we are going to make sure that we actually are going to see our output. And we're just going to select the media out and push 2. So this is what we have. And then it is just a question about actually putting all of these in the right order. But actually, what we can do now, we can just put all of these notes in, and we're going to put those into the merge node. And as you see, it's just going to add in bunch of things. As you see right here. And of course, this is also putting in a lot of
And there I put in the body of the woman. Maybe we don't want to have that right now. I'm just going to put that off. That's just for reference anyways. So we are going to plug in all of those here. And if I select the merge node here, I can go up here. And here I have all of the different layers. And then, you know, you have to run through them so to put them in the right order. So I'm just going to very quickly add in the body because I do need it. And like that. And I'm just going to move that way down. So now it's just a question of putting all of these things in the right order, and I'm going to do that super quickly, and I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, so here we have all of the different nodes connected in here, and of course this looks a little bit crazy because it is a lot of layers. However, we can now actually go in and animate the ones we want to animate. And for instance, if I want to go into the, let's say this, the flower layer here. So I can go in and I can obviously change a little here in the this animation here. Let's say we want to move this hand a little bit because that's how it was designed to do. So we could either do it this way, like I'm doing right now. Okay, and we're going to make sure that we are at the beginning of our time. And we're just going to put in a keyframe in the center and in the angle. And then we can just do, let's say, let's go over time to the end frame. And what I want to do, I want to make very small movements. So something like that. And then this should, of course, be here. Like that. So over time, we're going to make this very small movement, and it is a very small movement. And that's also the idea of this little animation, to make a super small movement. It shouldn't be that noticeable, but it is when you see it in movement, you can see now the hand are moving. And you know, this is what I want to do. I want to actually just move all of the different ones. So I also have the man's brows here, so maybe I can go to the beginning, and I want to, let's say, move this up a little bit. It's going to lift these eyebrows here a little bit. Again, putting in a keyframe, going into the end frame here, and then just do the small animation like that. And then I'll go into his eyes, and again, putting the keyframe here at the beginning. So maybe I want to move those like, so he's looking at his bride, like that. And this is what I'm going to do for the entire layers, just doing a super quick animation on all of them, or the ones I want to move at least. And then, you know, I'll show you the final result when we are done with that. So I'm just going to speed this up and come back in a few seconds. Okay, so here we are back, and I did this super small little animation. Now you can have a look here. It's a very subtle, small animation about this man and his wife. Cool. Of course, you could also have, you know, taken the individual nodes and put in a transform node, but now that wasn't really necessary, so we could actually do it like this. However, I do want to make a small zoom, and for that, I am going to take a transform node here from the workspace. I'm going to put that in between the multi-merge and the media out, and I just want to do a very small thing. I just want to, let's just zoom this out a little bit. Put in a keyframe at the beginning and then go to the end here. And I'm just going to size this up just a little bit like that. And I'm also just, for the sake of this, going to add in another transform node between the background and the multi-merge. And the main reason for doing that is I'm going to size the background up so we don't have that border. So that is what we have here. A super small little inzoom to a little animation done with multi-merge. And I know that this has a lot, really a lot of notes, but actually this is way easier to control compared to using merge nodes, because it is a really a lot of merge nodes you need to have. And then we'll just go into the edit page here and we can just have a look at it. There we go. Small little animation of this happy couple animated with PNG files inside of Fusion. One last thing you could do, and I think that is pretty cool, is you could just add in a little effect. I love to use this effect. I'm just going to go into the Open Effects. I'm just going to type in film, and then, you know, I'm just going to, I can use the analog damage and just put that on the clip here. Going up to the inspector and going into Open Effects, we can then change the film blur so it doesn't look that blurry, but, and we can change everything around just the way we want, like that. So now we have this little effect here done with the multi-merge node inside of Fusion and a kind of a little animation. I think this is pretty cool. And it's also, of course, an update to a very old, pretty popular video I have on the YouTube channel. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.